Hey guys, how's it going? So the Michigan quote assault weapons ban bill is here, and it's called House Bill 6544. I'm going to leave a link to this in the description as well as the pinned comment. And before you go shaking your head saying, but they always introduce these, no, this actually matters. And I've done two recent videos talking about the fact that gun control is going to be imminent in Michigan. We have a Democrat governor. In the upcoming session that starts in just a few weeks, a Democrat-controlled state House and a Democrat-controlled state Senate. So I'm going to read this to you. It's actually not very long. And then I'm going to show you a couple examples of rifles that are going to be banned. And one of them is going to be quite shocking if this bill were to pass. This is fresh off the press here. The ink's just starting to dry on it. This was introduced December 1st. 2022 by Representative Piper, and it's been referred to the Committee on Military, Veterans, and Homeland Security. It starts off, a bill to ban the manufacture, possession, purchase, and sale of assault weapons, to provide certain powers and duties for certain state and local officials and agencies, to provide for the promulgation of rules, and to provide penalties. This is going to be a felony. I'll get to that in a second. The people of the state of Michigan enact Section 1, as used in this act, quotes, assault weapon means a semi-automatic rifle that has the ability to accept a detachable magazine and has one or more of the following characteristics. I would note, it just needs the ability to accept a detachable magazine. Doesn't mean it has to have one currently inserted in it. Doesn't mean it had to come configured with one from the factory. And it does not list 10 rounds or 30 rounds. Just if it can accept any detachable magazine. Take note of that. Your mind's probably spinning as fast as mine is. This is almost all semi-automatic firearms. And has one or more of the following characteristics. First characteristic. It can only have one of these. There is no two or three like we've seen in past bans. It just needs one of these. A pistol grip or thumb hole stock. Thumb hole stock, that was always the workaround against a pistol grip. Now they just said it. A pistol grip or thumb hole stock. Any feature capable of functioning as a protruding grip that can be held by the non-trigger hand. Notice it doesn't say vertical foregrip. So anything that can function and be held by the non-trigger hand. In my opinion, by the plain reading of this, that could include bipod, flashlight, angled foregrip, basically anything out in front of the rifle. The next characteristic, a folding or telescoping stock. Now here's the kicker, and I want you to listen to this carefully. They're literally wanting you to burn yourself if you're going to shoot a gun, like cause physical burn injuries. In my opinion, you tell me what this says. A shroud that is attached to or partially or completely encircles the barrel that permits the shooter to hold the firearm with the non-trigger hand without being burned. No, like it literally just says that. If you have the ability to hold it with the non-trigger hand without being burned, but excluding a slide that encloses the barrel. So if there was a rifle with a slide. Almost done here. I'm going to show you an example of a couple guns. And then it goes on to say, except as otherwise provided in this section, beginning January 1st, 2024, a person shall not manufacture, possess, purchase, or sell an assault weapon in this state. Now here's the grandfather clause, and this is where unfortunately a lot of you are going to go, whew. It's okay. No, it's not okay. A grandfather clause is meant to sound like a compromise to you, to make you more complacent, and to make you okay with this. No, this is not good, because I'm going to read about this grandfather clause. A person may continue to possess an assault weapon that the person legally possessed before the effective date of this act if both of the following apply. A. The person registers the assault weapon with the Department of State Police, in compliance with rules adopted for that purpose by the Department of State Police. There we go. Put it on a registry. I know you've heard it before, but I'm going to say it again. Registration always has in the past, and in my opinion, always will lead to confiscation. B, the person renews the registration of the assault weapon every 5 years. It's not saying that here, but I'm assuming there's going to be some type of fee involved. But you'll have to re-renew it every 5 years. Here's the penalty. A person who violates subsection 1 is guilty of a felony, punishable by imprisonment for not more than 5 years. And then it concludes, section 3. The Department of State Police shall promulgate rules pursuant to the Administrative Procedures Act of 1969. That's huge. You know all this going on with the ATF right now? How they promulgated rules about pistol braces? That's going to be coming down any day now? Right here, it's authorizing the state police shall promulgate rules pursuant to the Administrative Procedures Act of 1969. So by the plain reading of that, and looking at how the ATF on the federal level uses the APA to redefine firearms law, quite frankly, in my opinion, make up firearms law on a whim, it appears that they would be giving the Michigan State Police similar powers and abilities to promulgate rules. So we could end up with, instead of just the ATF redefining a brace that's been legal for all these years into something other, we may find ourselves very soon with the Michigan State Police redefining what a certain characteristic or part of a firearm is. Here's an SKS. I'm a big fan of the SKS. I've owned them for many years. Now let's look at this. This is called the SKS Sporter. And here's the ironic part. This was brought into the country around the assault weapons ban of 94 era. Due to import restrictions, things like that, they would bring in guns like this to get around the now expired assault weapons ban that happened on the federal level, and some states still have that. Well, we'll look at it one more time. Plenty of wood, blued steel. It looks kind of like a FUD gun or a hunting rifle, doesn't it? It has a thumb hole stock so that it would not have a protruding pistol grip. Well, thumb hole stocks are explicitly banned and named as assault weapons in House Bill 6544. Well, even though this is only a 10-round magazine, it can accept and does take AK mags in this case. So it accepts detachable magazines. It can accept detachable magazines. Now, let's go back to the burning yourself again real quick here. A shroud that is attached to, it doesn't say and, it says or partially or completely encircles the barrel. So it's any one of the three. This definitely falls under this piece of wood, which is the fore end of the stock, here being the upper handguard for the gas tube. This partially encircles the barrel by definition, and it prevents the non-trigger hand, that's how it's worded in this bill, from burning yourself. So since this rifle prevents you from burning yourself while shooting it, it would also fall under an assault weapon. Now this is just by the plain reading of what the proposed bill says. Well, it is a bill, it's a proposed law. Democrats hold the governorship, the House, and the Senate of Michigan, keep in mind, coming here in just a couple weeks when the new session takes over. But hold on a minute, here's another SKS. All right, this has an integral 10-round magazine. So on the surface, you're thinking to yourself, it wouldn't qualify because it doesn't have a thumb hole stock. It doesn't have a pistol grip. Well, it does actually have something that I could, that protrudes, that I could use as a grip. Would that count? But here's the problem. Even this would be banned as an assault weapon because the duckbill mags exist for these. And it does not say that it has to have a detachable magazine. No, it says a semi-automatic rifle that has the ability to accept a detachable magazine. And these have the ability, even though this one is in completely stock configuration with the integral magazine, it does have the ability. So therefore, it would also be considered an assault weapon. All right, I'm going to leave a link down in the description how you can contact your representative in the Michigan House as well as your state senator. I encourage you all to do so. The Democrats do have a majority. It's very important that hopefully there's a somewhat pro-gun or in-the-middle Democrat that would vote against this. It's also very, very important to put the pressure on the Republican minority leadership to make sure they're not making any deals with the Democrats, and that hopefully no Republican would be okay with this, and hopefully we can convince a couple Democrats to reject this very short but very tyrannical bill. All right, guys, thanks for watching and have a good one.